Have another lesson on integers, and this time let's talk about operations on integers. Alright, okay, so first we're going to use counters, and the yellow counters would be positive, the red counters would be negative, right? And then kung magka-partner na ang isang positive at isang negative, you now have a zero pair. So, ito mga ito are zero pairs. Right? So, paano gagamitin natin our algebra tiles or just tiles in your modules? So, again, the yellow tiles will be positive. The red tiles would be negative. And kapag magka-partner na ang isang positive at isang negative, zero na ulit yan. So, again, these are zero pairs. Right? Now, isa pang gagamitin natin is number line. So, ito yung number line. And then, itong gitna would be zero. So, all the numbers to the left of zero are negative. All the numbers to the right of zero are positive. Right? Now, let's try it. Okay, so addition of integers. So we'll use the number line first. So ito yung pinakamadali. Okay, kung sakali maliliit lang na numbers ang i-add mo. So paano ba siya gawin? Okay, ito. Okay, positive 5 plus positive 4. So ito yung positive 5 mo. Pag sinabing plus positive 4, eh didagdagan mo ng positive 4. So apat na steps papunta sa kanan kasi positive eh. So, from positive 5, that would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So, stop tayo sa positive 9. So, positive 5 plus positive 4 is just positive 9. Another example, positive 2 plus positive 8. So, ito yung positive 2. Dagdagan ng positive 8. So, 8. So, isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim, pito, walo. So, tumigil ka sa positive 10. So, sagot dito is just positive 10. Okay? And then, positive 31 plus positive 4. Eh, paano ngayon yan? Hindi na natin makita dito. So, hindi sa lahat ng panahon madaling gamitin ang number line. Kaya lang, pwede mong isipin na saan yung positive 31. So, positive 31 ay nandun. Ang dagdagan mo lang ng 4, edi 31, that would be 32, 33, 34, 35. So, supposed to be, using the number line, titigil ka nito sa positive 35. Okay? So, madali lang ito kasi pareho lang namang positive yan. Now, paano kung negative yung isa? Tingnan natin ha. Or positive or negative dalawa. Tingnan natin. Okay, so, negative 6 plus positive 2. So, you have here negative 6 plus positive 2. Dagdagan ng dalawang positive. E di mula dito, dalawang positive pakanan. So, isa, dalawa. So, tumigil tayo sa negative 4. So, ang sagot dito is negative 4. Another one, we have positive 7 plus negative 10. So, nandito yung positive 7, dagdagan mo ng negative 10. Eh, negative 10, pakaliwa, di ba? So, 10 steps. So, that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, dito tayo tumigil. So, positive 7 plus negative 10 is equal to negative 3. Okay? And then, another one, negative 4 plus negative 5. So, ito yung negative 4, dagdagan ng negative 5. So, pakaliwa tayo kasi negative. So, 5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, you have there, ang sagot is negative 9. So, dito pa lang, makikita mo na you have an idea na kung anong gagawin if you're going to add integers. So, kung parehong positive, add mo lang. Ayan, no? I-add mo lang. Kopya yung sign. Now, kung parehong negative, ayan din, add mo lang. Kopya ang sign. Kaya lang, pag hindi pareho ang sign, okay, ima-minus mo siya. So, dito, 10 ang mas malaki. So, 10 minus 7, 3. Kaya lang, since negative ang sign ng 10, kinopya mo yung sign ng 10, which is negative. Kaya ang sagot natin is negative 3. Okay? Now, dito naman, negative 6 plus positive 2, minus ka ulit. 6 minus 2, that is 4. Okay? Now, since malaki ang 6 at ang sign niya ay negative, kaya ang sign natin dito is negative as well. Okay? Now, paano kung times ang gagamitin natin? Tingnan natin. Okay, so still with addition of integers. Now, meron na tayo ngayon dito positive 4. Kasi yellow ay positive, diba? So, positive 4 plus positive 3. E di kung ipagsama mo yan, e di 7 na lahat, diba? So, you could just say na positive 4 plus positive 3, yan, is equal to positive 7, diba? Now, another one. Again, positive 3. Now, ngayon, dagdagan natin ng positive 5. Pagsama mo yan, eh di meron ka ng 8, di ba? 2, 4, 6, 8. So, you would say na positive 3 plus positive 5 is just positive 8. Di ba? So, again, parehong positive lang yan. So, in-add mo, kopya yung sign na positive, di ba? Now, sunod nating example would be negative. Okay, so addition of integers pa rin. So, we have here negative 5 plus 1. E di, pagsama mo lang ulit, di ba? So, pagsama natin, that would be 6. So, this is just negative 5 plus negative 1 is equal to negative 6, di ba? Now, we have negative 2 plus negative 2. Pag pinagsama mo ulit, that would be negative 4, diba? So, again, that would just be negative 2 plus negative 2 is equal to negative 4. So, alam na natin na kapag parehong positive, add mo lang, kopyang positive sign, diba? Dito naman, parehong negative, add mo lang, kopya yung negative sign, diba? So, isa lang ibig sabihin nun. Okay? Ayan. Kapag pareho ang sign, add. And then, copy the common sign. So, kung parehong positive, positive. Kung parehong negative, and negative ang sagot mo. Okay? Again ha, same signs, add. And then, copy the common signs. Or the common sign. Alright? So, alam na natin na kapag pareho ang sign, add mo lang. Copy the common sign, di ba? Okay, so, paano kung hindi pareho ang sign? So, we are still on addition of integers, right? So, tignan natin ha, kung hindi pareho ang sign, paano kaya? Okay, so we have here positive 5. So, limang counters, limang positive counters. And then, apat na negative counters. So, positive 5 plus negative 4. Now, paano ngayon yan? Hindi pareho. E di ba alam na natin kapag nagpartner ang isang positive at isang negative, zero na yan, di ba? So kung ipagsama natin yan dito sa kabila, yan magpa-partner na ngayon ang isang positive at isang negative. So, ayan, so ang walang partner na lang ngayon ay itong isang positive. So, we have here positive 5 plus negative 4 ay magiging positive 1 lang yan kasi ito zero na yan eh. Hindi mo na ma-count yan. So, this is just positive 1. Okay? Now, another one. We have here, ayan. Ito na ngayon ay negative 6 plus positive 3. Kung ipagsama natin siya, ayan, ayan, magpa-partner ulit ang isang positive at isang negative. So, ang wala na lang partner dito ay tatlong negative. So, ito ngayon is negative 6 plus positive 3 is just negative 3. Yan. So, ibig sabihin lang nito, okay, kapag hindi pareho ang sign, subtract. So, pareho ito sa, in-explain ko doon sa, nag-add tayo gamit ang number line. So, kapag hindi pareho ang sign, subtract mo. And then, copy the sign of the digit with the greater value. So, kung ano man, kung alin man ang mas malaki, kopyahin mo yung sign niya. So, for example, dito, mas malaki ang 5. Ang sign ng 5, 5 is positive, kaya ang sagot natin dito is positive 1. Dito naman, mas malaki ang 6 kesa sa 3. And then, since ang sign ng 6 is negative, ang sagot natin ay nagiging negative 3. So, different signs, subtract, and then copy the sign of the digit with a greater value. Okay? Right? Subukan nga natin. Add the following. Okay, positive 5 plus positive 10. Parehong positive, edi add lang. So, that is positive 15. Positive 13 plus positive 6. Again, parehong sign, add lang natin. That is positive 19. Negative 8 plus negative 3. Parehong sign ulit, add natin. So, this is negative 11. And then, negative 10 plus negative 7, that is negative 17. Okay? And then, dito, iba na ang signs ng dalawa. We have negative 25 plus positive 5. So, minus tayo dito. So, 25 minus 5, that is 20. Diba? Now, since ang mas malaki ay 25 at negative siya, so this is negative 20. Okay? And then, this will now be... So, hindi parehong sign. This is positive 5, diba? And then, this one is positive 100 plus negative 100. Hindi parehong sign, minus. And then, since 100 yan at 100 to, edi 0 na lang, diba? And then, negative 6 plus positive 5, that would be negative 1. Negative 32 plus positive 10, that would be negative 22. And then, negative 12 plus positive 10, that is negative 2. Okay? Now, let's go ahead and touch on subtraction of integers. So, ayan, meron tayo ditong 5 positive tiles. Okay? And then, tatanggalin natin yung 2. So, positive 5 minus positive 2. Eh, di kitang-kita mo, oh, nawala na yung 2, eto na lang natira. So, that is just positive 3, di ba? So, again, positive 5 plus, minus pala, positive 2, that is positive 3. Okay? Now, another one, we have here, negative 4 this time. So, negative counters tayo. And then, tanggalin natin again yung 2. Okay? So, negative 4 minus negative 2. So, ang natira, eto na yung natira, diba? So, tinanggal lang naman natin. So, we have here negative 2. So, again, negative 4, gamit yung numbers, negative 4 minus negative 2 is just negative 2, diba? So, kung ganito, madali lang. Now, paano kung ganito? Okay. Still on subtraction of integers, ha? So, meron tayong positive 4 dyan. Okay? So, positive 4 and then sabi, i-minus natin ang negative 2. Now, paano ngayon yan? Wala namang negative dito, diba? Eh, didagdagan natin ang 2 zero pair. So, yun ang gamit ng zero pair. Magdagdag tayo dyan kasi kailangan mong kumuha ng 2 negative. So, kuha tayo ng 2 negative. Tanggalin natin yung 2 negative dyan. Okay? So, that is now again, positive 4 minus negative 2. Ayan, kinuha natin yung 2 negative 2. So, o 2 negative. So, ang sagot natin ay ito na ngayon, di ba? So, ang sagot natin is 6. So, again, positive 4 minus negative 2 is equal to positive 6. Okay? Kasi nagdagdag tayo ng 2 zero pair, ha? Now, another one. Okay, so, positive 4 minus negative 2. Kung titignan mo pala, i-observe mo yung numbers nila. Positive 4 and 2. Eh, ang sagot ay 6. Eh, di para ka lang palang nag-add nito. Ayan, no? Para ka lang palang nag-add ng kabaligtaran. So, eto lang ngayon ang susundan with subtraction. So, imbis na ituloy mo yung minus dito, gawin mo yung kabaligtaran kasi nag-add ka lang ng kabaligtaran nito. So, rewrite mo yan. That would be positive 4 plus positive 2 and that is equal to positive 6. So, ganun ang kaibahan ng subtraction of integers. So, hindi mo na ituloy yung subtraction. Baguhin mo siya, gagawin mo siyang addition, and then baguhin mo ang sign ng pangalawang number. Okay? So, ayan. So, ito lang yung tandaan mo. Keep the sign of the first number. So, ito yon. Keep mo yung sign nito, which is positive. In this example lang ha. And then, change subtraction to addition. Baguhin ang subtraction, gagawing addition, and then change the sign of the second number. Ito yung sign ng second number. Ginawa mo siyang positive from negative. And then, proceed with addition following the rules in adding integers. Para hindi ka magkamali, susundan mo lang ang rule na ito. At naka-blue ito para mas madaling maalala. So, ito lang tatlo ang tatandaan nyo. Ayan. Keep, change, change. So, keep the sign of this, change, subtraction to addition, and then change the sign of this, and you will get your answer. So, tignan natin paano natin gamitin, ha? Ayan, so subukan natin. Okay. Ayan. So, positive 20 minus positive 10. Keep, change, change. So, keep, this will be positive 20 plus negative 10. Diba? Ayan. So, positive 20 plus negative 10 and then proceed with addition. Since hindi pareho ang sign, i-minus natin. So, this is positive 10. Kasi mas malaki ang positive 20. So, again, negative 7 minus positive 4. Keep, change, change. So, this is negative 7 plus negative 4. Ayan. So, parehong negative. This is negative 11. Okay. Keep, change, change. So, again, this will be positive 8 plus negative 10. Ayan. So, this is now negative 2. Kasi hindi parehong sign, di ba? So, negative 2. And then, keep, change, change ulit. So, this is negative 9 plus positive 1. Ayan. So, this is now negative 8. Keep, change, change ulit. So, this is negative 100 plus negative 100. Ayan. Add the negative 200. And then, keep, change, change ulit. So, this is negative 10 plus negative 4, ayan, and that is negative 14. So, keep, change, change. Again, this is negative 50 plus negative 50, ayan. So, this is negative 100. And then, ulit, keep, change, change. So, this is negative 6 plus positive 15. Ayan, diba? And then, okay, ang sagot natin is positive kasi mas malaki ang 15. So, this is positive 9. And then again, keep, change, change. So, positive 25 plus negative 10. Ayan. So, this is now positive 15. And then again, keep, change, change. So, keep mo yung negative 10 and then plus positive 10. Ayan, hindi parehong sign, tapos parehong 10, edi minus. So, 0 ang sagot. Okay? Now, let's go ahead and have multiplication of integers. So, tignan natin kung paano gawin. Okay. We have positive 2 times positive 3. So, yung unang number, gawin natin itong the number of rows. So, dalawang row ng positive 3. Edi, ayan. Unang row, pangalawang row. So, ayan na yung sagot mo. Dalawang row ng positive 3. So, unang row, positive 3. Pangalawang row, positive 3 din. So, total lahat, edi 6. So, positive 2 times positive 3 is just equal to 6. Okay? And then, we have positive 2 times negative 4. Edi again, dalawang row ng negative 4. So, unang row, pangalawang row. So, you have there, bilangin natin, edi 2, 4, 6, 8, diba? So, positive 2 times negative 4, that is just negative 8. Okay? Now, we have here negative 2 times positive 5. Now, paano ngayon yan? Negative na ito. eh, yung in-example natin dati is positive 2, di ba? So, disregard muna natin yung negative, okay? Bilang muna tayo ng dalawang row ng positive 5. So, dalawang row ng positive 5. Unang row, okay, 5. Pangalawang row, 5. So, supposed to be, ang sagot natin dito is positive 10, di ba? Kaya lang, negative 2 ito eh. So, kung positive 2 yan, sakto na yung sagot natin. Kaya lang negative 2 ito. Kaya dapat kabaligtaran nito. So, i-flip natin ito. So, if you're going to make a tile or algebra tile, dapat yung baligtad nito is red. So, since kabaligtaran dahil negative 2 ito, edi flip natin yan. So, i-flip natin, meron ka na ngayong 10 red tiles. So, hindi na dapat positive 10 ang sagot natin. It should be negative 10. Okay? Now, another example nga. Okay, we have here positive 2 times positive 2. So, ito ulit. Dalawang row ng positive 2. So, ayan. Ayan. So, wala tayong problema dyan kasi parang positive naman eh. So, sagot natin is just 4, di ba? So, positive 2 times positive 2 is just 4. And then, positive 1 times negative 7, edi isang row ng negative 7. So, positive 1 times negative 7 pala. Okay? So, isang row ng negative 7. Ayan. So, since isang row lang naman, ayan na yung sagot mo. Positive 1 times negative 7 is just negative 7. Diba? Now, we have here negative 2 times negative 4. So, again, pareho ito sa kabila. Dalawang row ng negative 4. So, dalawang row ng negative 4. Ayan. So, supposed to be, sagot natin is negative 8. Kaya lang, since negative 2 ito, kabaligtaran nito. Diba? Kasi negative eh. So, flip natin itong counters. This will now be, ayan, positive na. So, negative 8 na sagot natin dati should be positive 8 na. So, negative 2 times negative 4 is already positive 8. Okay? So, kung titignan mo dito, ayan o, parehong positive, sagot mo ay positive. Parehong negative, ayan, positive ulit. So, ibig sabihin lang nun, pag parehong sign, positive. So, kahit pa parehong positive yan or parehong negative, positive pa rin dapat ang sagot. Okay? Now, kung hindi pareho ang sign, edi negative. So, siguro magtatanong kayo, ma'am, paano kung dito yung negative? Ito yung positive. Edi ganun lang din, isang row ng positive 7, di ba? Kaya lang, kung ito yung negative, flip mo siya ulit eh. So, imbis na positive, edi magiging negative. Negative ulit siya. Kasi kung positive to, di ba? So, ganun pa rin. Lalabas pa rin siya na negative. Okay? So, ang tatandaan lang with multiplication of integers is just same signs, positive. Parehong sign, positive. Hindi parehong sign, negative. Okay? So, yun lang. Pareho mang positive, positive pa rin yan. Parehong negative, i-multiply mo, positive pa rin. Okay? Pero pag hindi pareho ang sign, automatic negative. Okay? Tignan natin with these examples. Subukan nating sagutan. Ayan. So, positive and positive, this is positive. Okay? So, positive 20 times 2, that's positive 40. Negative and negative, edi positive. Diba? So, negative 8 times negative 3, that is positive 24. Negative and positive, dapat sagot natin dito is negative. So, this is negative 50. And then, positive and negative, again, negative sagot natin dito, that is negative 30. And then, this one is negative and positive, negative ulit. This is negative 18. And then, positive and negative, again, this is negative 100. And then, negative and positive, okay, so 6 times 2, negative 6 times positive 2, that's negative 12, right? And then, now, paano ito? Tatlo. Okay, edi one at a time lang. So, eto muna ang dalawa. Okay? Eto muna. So, negative and positive. So, negative 3 times positive 2, that is negative 6. So, negative 6 times negative 3, edi magiging positive 18 na yan. Okay? And then, dito. Ayan. positive and negative, positive 10 and negative 10, that would be negative 100, tama? So, negative 100 times negative 10, edi positive na yan, positive 1,000. Okay, now, paano ngayon ito? Apat ito, puro negative. So, tignan natin ha, edi sigurado ka ng positive ito, di ba? Kasi parehong negative lahat eh, pero tignan natin. Okay, now, negative 3 times negative 3, that's positive 9. Tama? So, positive 9 times negative 3, that's negative 27. So, kung hanggang dito lang sana, sagot natin ay negative. Kaya lang, may isa pang negative 3. So, negative 27 na sagot natin dito sa tatlo, negative 27 times negative 3, edi magiging positive na, and that is positive 81. So, depende, okay? Kapag sa isa lang, okay? And then, let's have division of integers. So, positive 8 divided by positive 2. So, meron tayo ditong 8 tiles. So, positive 8, edi hatiin lang sa dalawa. Edi i-group mo into 2. So, isa, dalawa. So, ilan ngayon bawat group? Eh, kung bibilangin natin, you have 1, 2, 3, 4. Diba? So, ang sagot natin dito would just be 4. So, positive 8 divided by positive 2 is just positive 4. Okay? And then, yan, negative 9 ngayon divided by positive 3. E di meron tayo dapat siyam dito na negative. So, di, eto ngayon ay negative counters. So, negative 9, 3, 6, 9, di ba? And then, hatiin sa tatlo. Di isa, dalawa, tatlo. So, bawat hati ay meron tayong tatlong negative. E di sagot natin is just negative 3. So, again, negative 9 divided by positive 3 is just negative 3. Now, ngayon, paano ito? Negative 2. Divided ay negative 4 divided by negative 2. Adi simula muna tayo sa negative 4. So, apat yun, di ba? So, negative 4, ayan. Divided by negative 2. Adi hatiin muna natin sa dalawa. Ayan, hati sa dalawa. So, kung titignan mo, bawat hati ay may dalawa. Diba? So, supposed to be, sagot natin is negative 2. Kaya lang, hindi pa natin ginawa yung negative dito. Kasi, kung divided by 2, eto na yun, diba? Kaya lang, negative 2 kasi yan. Kaya, flip na naman tayo. Pareho dun sa ginawa. So, multiplication, flip natin ito. So, this will now be positive. Ayan. So, imbis na negative 2, bawat group, that is now positive 2. Okay? So, kung titignan nyo, pareho lang ito sa multiplication. Ayan o. Parehong positive, positive ang sagot. Parehong negative, positive pa rin ang sagot. Pag hindi pareho ang sign, negative ang sagot. So, yon ang magiging comparison sa multiplication. Pareho lang sila. Okay? So, again, pareho dun sa multiplication, same signs, positive, different signs, negative. Yun lang yun. Okay? So, tignan natin paano sagutan. So, let's divide. Okay? Let's divide the following. Okay. Now, we have positive 10 divided by positive 2. So, parehong positive yan. So, sigurado dapat ang sagot natin ay positive. So, this is just positive 5. So, number 2, we have negative 8 divided by negative 2. So, again, parehong negative. So, ang sagot natin should be positive. So, this is positive 4. Negative 18 plus, negative 18 divided by positive 3. So, hindi pareho ang sign. Negative dapat ang sagot natin. So, this is negative 6. Okay? And then, positive 6 divided by negative 3. Again, hindi parehong sign. Negative. Ayan. So, this is negative 2. Take note nyo dapat yung signs. Kasi, dun tayo lagi nagkakamali. Ha? So, this one is negative 9 divided by positive 3. Again, this is negative. So, this is negative 3. And then, positive 10 divided by negative 10. So, again, hindi parehong sign. That is just negative 1. And then, we have negative 60 divided by positive 2. Again, that is a negative. So, negative 30. And then, negative 25 divided by negative 5. Now, since pareho na ang sign dito sa dalawa, dapat sagot natin ay positive. So, this is positive 5. And then, positive 15 divided by negative 5. So, this is negative 3. Ayan. And then, last, negative 30 divided by negative 10. Again, parehong negative. That would be positive 3. Alright?